Hey YouTube, yeah, this is BC in 3D, and I'm basically doing a video going to Superior, Montana. Essentially in Superior, a couple times a week, I walk its perimeter, get some exercise, but I thought it'd be kind of cool to get some 3D shots of the little town and the things I see, and I'll show you a couple of stories as well. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get this footage all in one day or not. It depends on how well the battery lasts on this Qoocam Ego. So it's only going to be done with one camera. I usually have another camera, the Sony Vloggy, and I work with both of them because the Sony Vloggy does have a way of showing the close-up shots better because the lenses are closer together. But Qoocam is very nice when it comes to its color and its resolution in doing stuff in 3D. So anyway, I'm gonna stop this and then we will resume in Superior. Okay, so this is kind of where it began with the Qoocam Ego for me with this camera. In 2022, I started down here working, and it was at this gas station. Pilot, Exxon, everything. So we're a quarter mile down by the overpass. I'm gonna let Mr. Carr pass by here. I want him to think I'm trying to film him. There's the ramp to that gas station. Actually, this is kind of a nice little Baptist church that we have up here. This is off the beaten path. I usually do the perimeter, and this isn't on the perimeter. I just wanted to do a quick clip of this. But they did invite me to this church, and that normally doesn't happen with churches these days. It's pretty funny. It's also a kind of a cool church because it doesn't follow the Reformist ideology of marriage, divorce, and remarriage, which I personally appreciate, even though there are many who would not. So I was looking for my selfie stick earlier this morning. Couldn't find it, so my arm is going to have to do here. So what am I doing in the middle of a baseball field? Well, you know, around the ballpark of the 1 mile mark, this is where it sits me. So here we are, 1 mile into my walk, which ends up being at the end about 4.5 miles. But yeah, this is kind of where my first mile just kind of puts me in the middle of. Have to avoid the sprinklers too. Sometimes the sprinklers going out on over there, and I don't know. It's the little things, I guess. This is really kind of disappointing. No, don't get me wrong, the scenery is gorgeous. Just a few moments ago, I was able to see a heron out on the lake, and he was actually relatively close. And I was trying to get a picture of him with my cell phone. But when I tried to go around the bushes again, he saw me and he flew away. So it's very unfortunate because it's one of the coolest things about this this part of the Clark Fork River. I don't know if you can see him, but there's a duck down there. Ooh, there's lots of ducks down there. Sorry, folks, no zoom on the camera. But no herons, just ducks. And here's a map of Superior and its surrounding location. So this is the other side of the river. Every bit is beautiful. It's usually on that sand bank over there that I see the herons. So it kind of surprised me that I saw one on the other side today. And he was so close. Oh, another kind of interesting thing. I don't know if you can see with the camera. Maybe sometime I will get down there and get close enough to that that water outlet. Now it kind of makes it look like a little waterfall, and then you see the stupid pipe behind it. But if I get close enough, it probably would make a kind of neat little shot. So this puts us at the 2 mile mark. In front of us, behind me, is the library. And talking about the do you know type situation, do you know that there's a streaming service that requires you to have a library card in order to enjoy free commercial-less movies? So they keep ads off of them. A lot of older 70s films, 80s films. It's called Canopy, and it... Canopy with the letter K, not C. And it requires you to get a library card. And so I got myself a library card from this library a couple months ago so I could enjoy some of these films. So, the more you know. So I think it's kind of cool that they have an Assembly of God church in a town this small. This town only has about 1,000 people in it. But it's only on Sunday. I was kind of hoping for something a little bit more midweek. During the weekends I work, and it makes it really hard to come to certain places like this. So to be honest, it's actually a kind of a boring walk at this point, at least until we get to the park on the other side. So I'll make mention of when we hit the 3 mile mark and where I'm at there. But yeah, there's not a lot to show here. That one looks pretty good. Okay, I just wanted to get the trees and mountains in the background. This is mile 3, and so there's a... It's on the eastern perimeter of town, and there's a church over there that you usually see from the freeway. We're going to be traveling down the road down here, past the golf course, and then we'll hit go walk by the hospital, and yeah, so there's a couple more things to see. But so far this camera's battery power is running well, so we should be able to get everything that we need to get to today. So this is the hospital, Mineral County Hospital, and it also has a clinic and a public health department. I had a little scare last year with my health, and so I had to come here last summer. So currently I'm paying on a hospital bill, but I should have it paid off until before Christmas hits this year. But it's definitely a place that, yeah, it has memories. So, yeah. Alright, so, small towns and our landmarks, huh? This is a Keystone Drill. It's located on the corner of the fairgrounds here in Superior. Kind of a cool little thing. Probably looks really cool in 3D. right, behind me is the school, which is kind of a funny place for a school, right behind the fairgrounds. So yeah, every year they hold a fair here, no rides, just a few exhibits and some vendors, but it's free to attend, so it's a pretty fun thing here in the town of Superior. When the fair is going on, there are a lot of signs of this nature around the town. However, because this is the entrance for the rodeo, this is they probably don't mind the animals being in this area so much. In fact, just ask Dave. So yeah, we are at the park now. No animals allowed. No fireworks. A couple park rules there. And you can only go a maximum of 15 miles per hour on the grass. So do not exceed past 15 miles per hour on the grass. Might fall and get grass stains on your jeans. They do have a bathroom over there. When I do these walks, it's quite a lifesaver. It is 2024. This is supposed to be the future home of the community pool. It'd be cool if they did this within a year or two. But this this video can act as a as evidence of how long it actually takes to do it. I don't know how long the sign has been up. It's been up as long as I've lived in the area, a couple years, I believe. I'm just taking this photo because it looks like it's going to be really cool in 3D. Again, the bathrooms with the park name there. And here we have the Superior Skate Park. Welcome. And there it is. In fact, let's go ahead and take a look at that real quick. They usually don't come in so it would be kind of hip to bring a camera like this out to this place when people are skating around, I suppose. All right, and guess what, guys? The skate park actually brings us right to mile 4. So I can guess that we've got about a half mile to go before we reach the gas station again. I just want to catch some trees here behind me. I mean, what's the use of having a 3D camera if you can't catch some good composition, right? Just a couple of attractions here. This is S&S. There are some charging units right there by this gas station. Also, the town's restaurant, Durango's, with its gift shop and a small casino. And their Big Sky Motel is also here. Okay, so I just need to make it up this hill and where my vehicle is. And that was kind of the walk around Superior. Might have some shots later on with the town as well. I hope everyone has a good day, and I'll talk with you later.